Hello, all the students of Standard 3. Good morning. I hope you all are well in this pandemic coronavirus. Please stay home, stay safe. Spend your quality time with your family member. You can give your quality time in your study also. I hope whatever homework I am giving you in maths and science, you are doing it on time. So today I am going to teach you maths. Okay, chapter 9. So whenever you are going to watch my video, please keep book and copy with you. Okay. And one more thing, in earlier classes I told you that your exam is going to start in the second week of September. So I hope syllabus is also updated on the school website. So please go and see. And whatever syllabus is there, you just read it. There will be MCQ type question. Okay, 25% will be there, full mark is 50. So please prepare for this. I hope you will do some great things. So today I'm going to start chapter 9, page number 78. Okay. Chapter is fractional numbers. Chapter 9 is new chapter fractional numbers. Okay. So I think you have already you already know that fraction. What is fraction? Okay, fraction contains actually two parts. One part, the upper part is, there is two part, upper part and down part, like 5 by 6. Okay, so fraction, this is actually called a fraction. In a fraction, the upper part is known as numerator. Spelling is N-U-M-E-R-A-T-O-R, and the down part is called spelling is D-E-N-O-M-I-N-A-T-O-R. Okay, so here is no example. So see if the size 29 in the one question I will give you. After that, the rest question you will do it by course. Means question number 1, 2, 3, 4 are same. So one is size 29, question number 1 is the same. Change your figure. This. This part is shaded. This part is also shaded. First question is, in how many equal parts is the figure divided? Okay, in how many equal parts is the figure divided? So, figure is divided into 1, 2, 3. 3 parts. Okay? A figure is divided into 1, 2, 3 equal parts. Okay, this I just made wrong figure. Okay, 3 parts. Now, how many parts are shaded? How many parts are shaded? So, 1, 2. 2 parts are shaded. How many parts are shaded? 2 parts are shaded. Third is, write the fraction for the shaded one. You have to write the fraction. The fraction will always contain numerator and divisor. See, in question number 2, it said only how many parts. It does not ask that how many fraction. But in question number C, it says write the fraction for the shaded portion. See, first 1, 2, 3. 3 parts are there, means total 3 parts. So this total 3 is denominator. How many parts are shaded? Write a fraction for the shaded portion. So 1 and 2 part is shaded. It means 2 by 3 part is shaded. You have to write a fraction. So that's why how many parts are shaded? 1 and 2. So write 2. How many numbers are the total number of parties? 1, 2, 3. So write 3. Okay? Now come to question number D. Write the fraction for the unshaded part. Unshaded. So see, this figure, one part is unshaded. So how many parts is unshaded? 1. You have to write fraction. So 1, 2, 3. Total part is 3. So write 1 by 3 part is unshaded. Whenever here is written that write fraction, and fraction will always contain numerator and denominator. Okay, friend? So with the help of this, you easily solve the size 3, can easily solve the size 20. Okay, there are some more questions in there. Like how many 7, how many 1/3 are there in a whole? Question is how many 1/3? How many 1/3 are there in a whole? Okay. So how many 1/3 are there in a whole? 3. So there is 1 means there is 3. Answer will be 3 for 7. Question is how many 1/3 there is in a whole? So see, 3. How? So see, 1 by 3 when you will add, answer will be 3. 1 plus 1 means 3 by 3. When you will get the answer. It means 1, 2, 3 means there are 3 1/3 in a whole. So same question you can see here. And how many 1/5 are there in whole? So 5. Now we move to next question. 11. Read the following fractional number. Okay? Question number 11. There is no example, that's why I am explaining question. Okay? Read the following fraction numbers. How you will read? Read the following fraction numbers. Means first, 2 by 5. What answer you will write? Okay? How you will read? So you just simply write 2 by 5. Very easy. You can write this 2 by 5. Okay? Or you can write 2 over 5. One more thing you can write, or you can write 2, and denominator you can write 5th. If there is 3 by 5, then you can write 3/5. Okay? So either you can write this way. So we can read this 2 and this 5, you can read 2 by 5, 2 over 5 and 2/5. So, if you want to write this, you can go through this. If you want to write this, or if you want, anyone if you want to write, you can go. Okay? Now, question number 2 is, write the following fractional number. Okay, now it is given in word. You have to write the fractional number. So, very easy. 1 by 5 written. So, 1 by, this is by and 5. The answer is 1 by 5. Very easy. Now 13, write the numerator of each of the following. In 13, you have to write the numerator of each of the following. So in this, you will write that 3 is numerator. In 14, you have to write denominator. So just write 12 is denominator. Okay? Now 15. Write the fraction whose numerator is 15. Numerator is given like 7 and denominator is given 13. In solution, you have to write the fraction. Okay? What will be the fraction? So, numerator is given 7, denominator is 13. That's why 7 by 13. Numerator always you will write on top, denominator always you write down. Now, question number 16 is, find the fraction in which the denominator is 3 more than the numerator. Okay. In 16, some number are there, like 6 by 9. You have to find the fraction in which the denominator is 3 more than the numerator. So, see, here is 6 numerator. Denominator is 9. It means here denominator is what? 3 more than. 6 plus 3, 9. Here the question is that you have to, here are some number is there in that, and you have to choose the number. So yes, 6 by 9 is, in this 6 by 9, 3 is more than the numerator. Okay. And 17, how many halves make a whole? Question 17 is how many halves make a whole? 1 by 2, how many halves make a whole? So answer will be 2. How? 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. How many halves make a whole? So answer will be 2. So exercise 29.